Hello and good morning, friends. Today I want to talk to you about a question I get asked every now and again about, I have marshy soil all around my septic tank. What could possibly be going on? And I want to kind of dive into this and tell you a little bit about what might be happening and ways that you as a homeowner can try and do a little bit of self-diagnosis before you call that professional and spend all that money for them to tell you what's going on, right? Let's get into it. So, you're mowing the lawn, right? Hasn't rained in 3 weeks. The dirt is so dry that you can't even put a shovel in it without having to work real hard to do so. But you're mowing the lawn and you get a little bit too close to the septic and the tire starts to spin and you just create a huge rut in your yard. First thought is, oh no, what could possibly be going on? You want to look and see where around that tank is that marshiness coming from, right? So generally in our area, as septic systems start to fail, right, you won't necessarily see too much ponding or stagnant water in the drain fields. You'll usually see it in the tank first. And if you ignore it long enough, then you'll usually see it in the drain fields. And you might be saying, wow, that doesn't make sense. That's not how that works in our area, which is fine. But in our area, the tanks and the absorption systems are deep enough to where, you know, it's a little bit more uncommon for that to happen. The average tank depth in our area is about 1.5 feet or greater, right? So they're usually between 18 inches and 36 inches below the surface. So if that's the case, that means the drain fields are going to be anywhere from 20 inches to 48 inches below the surface. We have a lot more clay in this area than maybe if we went to like the eastern shore of Maryland. So what'll happen is that confining layer up top will actually keep most of the water down. Now, water will always go where the path of least resistance is. If it's easier for the water to bubble up, guess what? It's going to bubble up. If it's easier for it to go back to the tank, guess what? It's going to go back to the tank. So generally in our area, how you'll see that you have a septic issue is it'll be in the tank first. So back to this story of you're mowing your lawn, right? So you mow your lawn and you see this marshiness around your tank. First thing you're going to do is you're going to make sure that you open the lid and see what's going on inside of there, right? Most of the risers in our area are not watertight, so that would be where most of your marshiness would come from. The tank itself would back up and it would work its way through the seams in the riser or out of the lid of the tank itself. Over the course of many days and or weeks and or months of backups, it'll eventually make the soil really, really wet, all right? So you pop open the tank, you want to look inside. The water level in our area, the way that these tanks are constructed, you should always have about 1 foot between the top of the tank and the bottom of the tank. If there's not any kind of separation or space, that generally means that you have an issue with the drainage. So general drain field lifespan in our area is generally about 30 to 40 years. So if you have a 50-year-old system and you start to see this marshiness, there's a good chance that you have a failure in the absorption system. So you open the tank, if the water level's all the way up, now we know the water's not exiting the tank properly, right? But let's just say what happens if you open it and the water level's right where it belongs. So generally what I would recommend is at that point, run a little bit of water, see what it does, right? Let's just say you put 100 gallons of water in there. So if you've got 12 inches of space between the water and the top of the tank, you put 100 gallons of water in, you see that you lose 4 inches of space. Well, if you put another 100 gallons of water in and you lose 8 inches of space, now you know that the tank is not draining correctly, right? So your options could either be a partial clog, a partial collapse, or a failure in your absorption system, right? The first two are way easier to address, but it also kind of depends on how old that house is, right? So in our area, generally partial collapses don't happen unless somebody built something on the tank, drove over the tank, drove over something they weren't supposed to. Now, if you go to a home that was built before 1980 and they had cast iron pipe, Orangeburg pipe, terracotta pipe, it's more common for something like that to just out of nowhere fall apart and collapse, right? Dirt's heavy. So if you have a three feet of dirt on top of the pipe, it is very possible that that pipe just collapses on its own because of the weight of the dirt. So the partial obstruction, that one's a little bit more annoying. Generally, what would cause that is if the baffle is not in place and you have scum just constantly going into the pipe and plugging it up, right? But we're here to talk about marshy soil. So if the drain field is no longer draining correctly, what'll happen is the water will work its way back to the tank. usually when you open that tank up, you'll see rings inside of the tank or staining on the concrete. That tells you that the water level has risen and has stayed high for quite a while, enough to stain either the riser or the concrete itself. If your drain field's not working, the additives that people will sell you, there's no proof that any of that stuff works. You might be able to buy yourself 6 months, 12 months to at least get the funding put together to put in a new drain field. But in our area, if the drain field's saturated and no longer draining, it's time to replace it and put in another set of drain fields. And then that'll last you another 30 or 40 years, right? But there are products out there that people will use to try and rejuvenate everything. Until those things have more of a success rate, I can't tell you to do it. In my opinion, it's kind of a waste of money right now, right? So if you have marshy soil, it's very important to make sure that you're not playing in it, right? It is sewage water, potentially. It is possible that it could be groundwater, but again, in this hypothetical, it hasn't rained in quite a while. So it's important to make sure that you get this addressed as soon as possible. If you figure out after you run a little bit of water that the tank's not working correctly, it's backing up, sometimes you can also pump the tank and that can buy you some time. It might buy you a week, maybe 2 weeks before you have a chance to have somebody come out to start the process of replacement. In our area, usually you're talking about 2-3 weeks to get everything done, and that's just because the county has to get involved and they take their sweet old time, right? But if you get the tank pumped once or twice, that should buy you enough time to where you don't have to worry about any of that soil getting wet or any potential backups into the home. If you're really unlucky, again, if the water goes where it wants to go, wherever the path of least resistance is, it is potential that that water could come back to the house, and nobody wants sewage water in their basement, right? So I hope this was helpful, right? If you found this interesting or useful, hit that like button, hit subscribe. Tell me below, have you ever had to deal with a backup in your septic system? Have you ever had to replace a drain field? These conversations are helpful for everybody who's listening. Share your story. You might help somebody else go through whatever they're going through, right? Till next time, guys.